Hello learners, welcome to a new session of ABM 3510. The course title is Agro Processing Management and the credit hours are 2, 1 plus 1, that is 2. Okay, so in the Agro Processing Management course, in this course, what all things we have to cover is the definition of agro processing, food processing units, the agro processing management's industries, the role of agro processing industries to Indian economy, and what are the different kinds of processing units, and what are the kinds of value addition that happens. All those things we will be learning. So in the first lecture today, we will be learning or we will understand what is agro processing, like what is actually the processing, or how this is adding value, and what is the importance of agro processing in the viewpoint of a customer, and how it is contributing or how it is adding value to a producer. All those things today we will be understanding. So initially we will learn what is the definition of agro processing. Agro processing may be defined simply as a set of techno-economic processing activity that is performed to maintain or to improve the quality or to change the form and or characteristics of agriculture produce in order to meet the food and nutritional requirements of the people in relation to their needs. So simply what it is the techno-economic processing activity undertaken to maintain improve the quality or maintain or improve the quality or change the form and characteristic of agriculture produce so that the food and nutritional requirement of the people in relation to the present need can be catered. Okay, so the other definition is agro processing is defined as a set of techno-economic processing activities that we have understood earlier. So how would this happens applied to all the producers originating from agricultural like the crop production, whether it is a horticulture, floriculture, or vegetables, or whatever be that, from originating from agricultural farm, livestock, aquaculture sources, and forest for their conservation, handling, and value addition to make them usable as food, feed, fiber, fuel, or industrial raw materials. Okay. Now we'll see what are the activities that are undertaken in this agro processing industries or agro processing units. The first one is protection. Protection from what? Protection or conservation from the spoilage. Okay. Next is prevention, preservation, and conservation. Preservation and conservation means it is making safe for the storage. Okay. Next activity undertaken is processing. Processing means changing the form or characteristic. Next is packaging. Packaging for better quality and shelf life. Next is distribution. By distribution, it helps to attain the place utility. Next is marketing. And finally, utilization. Utilization means consumption by the consumers. Okay. Or this agro processing can be also called as food processing. Okay. So what are the major things or major application techniques that happens in food processing? We will see. We have seen in agro processing, now we'll discuss about food processing. Food processing refers to the application of techniques in to food in a systematic manner. So for preventing the losses through preservation, just like that we have learned in agro processing, packaging, storage, and distribution. Okay, so now we have understood what is food processing and agro processing. Now we will see how important is this food processing and how it is contributing. So how it is important from the perspective of a consumer or a customer and from a producer, that we will understand. So the first point, from how it is benefiting a consumer, the food agro processing, how it is benefiting a consumer, is the first point is to ensure greater availability of wide variety of foods. So wide variety of the foods and the availability of the wide variety of foods is made. Second is to improve the food intake and nutritional standards during the periods of low availability. When the food is available in low quantity or less quantity, at that time the improved food intake and nutritional value can be contributed through this processing. Next point is to save time, which is required for cooking. Because if we, for example, if you know the wheat is a raw form. If we want to cook that, it takes too much of time. When we have the wheat flour, that helps us to convert into chapatis or whatever be the consumable form. It is easy to consume. Like it is, the process will be easy. So this processing, the conversion of one form to the other helps in saving the time. At the same time, help the food intake and nutritional standards. Next, also the availability of the food variants or a different variety of food is available. So these are certain importance or certain benefits that the food processing or agro processing contributes to the customer. Now we will see to the producer how it is contributing. The first is it will be created into an edible or usable consumable form. Next is increased storability, the shelf life can be increased due to the processing. Next is create more easily transportable form, because you know the sugar cane once harvested, it will be long sticks that will be difficult to carry or transport. Once it is transformed into jaggery, that is very easy to transport. Just like all the agriculture produces, it is difficult to handle or distribute or transport at the in the raw form. Once it is processed or semi-processed, then it will be easy to transport and distribute. Next is enhance nutritional value. It adds nutritional value once the processing is done. Next is to get higher returns by value-added processed food. For example, the fruits, once we are converting that into jam, jelly, squash, it is adding value. And the returns from them is also increasing. Next, to create employment. The processing industry contribute to more than 40% of the job creation to the Indian community. So these are the major benefits of agro processing units or industries. So why the management of agro processing units is necessary? It helps. The management of agro processing units is to get maximum output with maximum profit through application of various techno-economic processing activities to all the agriculture products. So why it is the management of agro processing units, what it does, it aims to get maximum output with maximum profit through the application of various technical or economical processing activities. Okay, so I hope the initial sessions regarding agro processing and the activities undertaken in agro processing is clear. So it was an introductory session. I hope the concepts are clear. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.